Hi, good afternoon, everybody and the august audience. To everybody here on the dais, Patil sir and distinguished speakers who are here on the dais to speak about solar at the conference. The organizers of the conference, thank you for organizing this. I think, very frankly speaking, as Mr. Rangwal also said, I think we've been lacking events in the state. Events which can share information, events which can share standard, events which can share best practices. We need more of such events all the time. So thank you for organizing this. Thank you for taking the lead, EQ. Thank you to the audience for coming here this morning, and we hope to talk to you after the conference also, or whenever you have the time. My name is Karan Dangayach. I represent a company called Shashwat Cleantech. We started it in 2010. We are basically, what you can say, a little beyond a startup stage company. I'll be trying to talk. I'm not enlightened, as Chetan sir said. I'm not as enlightened, but yeah, I'll try to talk about decentralized applications and some of our views on the same. So basically, you know, one of the very interesting things happened in 2012. I was traveling in Indonesia, and I don't know if any of you know, what is diesel called in Indonesia? Does anybody know? Yeah, it's over there, so it's obvious, but I should have asked you the question before the putting on this slide, but yeah. So it's very interesting, but in Indonesia, diesel is basically called solar. So when I was traveling, I used to see these solar boards all along the roads in the villages, and I used to think, where is solar? So then, you know, I went and asked one of the guys who was selling these bottles. They basically sell it in bottles of usually Absolute vodka. Sorry, we are in Gujarat, but they sell diesel in bottles of Absolute or other liquors, and it's all across Indonesia. So I went and asked this gentleman, where is solar? So he said, this is solar. So I was like, okay, fine. So I mean, that was a big learning, and I think it is a coincidence that, you know, we've become quite big in replacement of diesel with our solar pumps along the way in the last 5 years. Essentially, I think we've spoken about a lot of numbers today, so I'll breeze through and I'll try to stick to the time as well. But essentially, we all know that, you know, renewable energy sources are now at probably about 50,000 megawatts as a contribution of the entire power generation scenario in the country. Out of that, I would say that decentralized is a very, very small part. It is, I would say, not even 2% right now, which is probably only about 1,400 megawatts. So there is a huge amount of potential, because we as a country are, and I'll talk only about India, but this can apply to a lot of emerging markets, that we as a country are essentially hugely disparate. We are very hard to reach. We've got huge number of states which are very tough to actually pull electricity lines up to, and most of our electricity requirement in rural areas is basically for either small amount of lighting or small amount of refrigeration, or most of the time for pumps. So pumps basically contribute, if you see the figures, and I don't have them here, but the pumps basically contribute about 70% of the power which is actually being sent to the rural areas in India. And that is a huge opportunity. In fact, it is probably equivalent to the megawatt scale plants that are being installed all across the country and the world. So the potential to make an impact is huge, because if you look at India, we've got approximately the Shakti Foundation, which is a think tank in Delhi. They published a report. They said that India has got somewhere between 25 to 30 million agricultural pumps running across the country. These pumps could either be on diesel, these could be on electricity, or these could be on electricity which is not available to them all the time because of the poor infrastructure. And there are 30 million pumps in the country only for agriculture. Now, replacing all of these with solar is the kind of opportunity which makes us wake up in the day and go to office, because replacing all of these would really contribute in a big way, not only to increasing the efficiency at the farm level, but also for the electricity companies. Also, one more opportunity that lies when you look at pumps, and I'm talking about decentralization specifically, decentralized applications, more about pumps, because we have more, I would say, experience in pumps. When you install pumps on the ground, you can also monitor them. And when you install, when you start monitoring them, you try to understand what is the kind of water which is being pulled out by the farmers from the ground. And as we all know that India is massively overexploited in terms of the groundwater. We are the largest user of groundwater in the world today, largest. So if you actually start installing solar pumps and also try to understand the kind of water which is being pulled out, that can contribute in a huge way to what Mr. Shankar was saying, to the agri productivity of the country. Because the water can be monitored, you can actually have interventions which make farming more efficient, which will only be possible if you have got something like a solar pump device or a device inside a solar pump, which is possible now to monitor the water which is being pulled out. And it is safe to say that water is actually the next oil, because water is the, everybody talks about this, water is actually going to be the reason for if there's a next world war, or if there's any other kinds of wars, water is going to be the reason for that. So how can we make an impact as a country? How can we make an impact as a state? You know, one of the things that that I would like to say is that we need to actually map out the life cycle cost of delivering energy to rural areas. That is not being done well enough. We have had meetings with various officials, and everybody agrees that the cost of delivering power to the farmer today is not less than 8 rupees. It is not less than 8 rupees. If you consider the losses, the electricity inefficiencies, the langasiyas which are put on the electricity lines when you are transporting the or transfer transmitting the electricity, it is not less than 8 rupees. And solar can do the job. We all know that, you know, people are signing PPAs, but even if you consider those PPAs to be very aggressive, I would say solar can do that job safely within 5.5 rupees. So it makes so much more sense for the country to entirely go on solar pumps. And I'm only surprised that it is not being done in a very, very aggressive manner. Also, financing decentralized via standardized online and scalable schemes is also the need for the hour, because every state has got its own scheme. I don't know, we talk about us as a unified country, but it is a joke. I mean, every state releases a scheme, even like you are here, sir. We've got a scheme for solar pumps for electricity companies. Then we've got a scheme for solar by Gujarat Green Revolution Company. Then GWSSB will release its own scheme for solar pumps. It should be a unified scheme for the entire country for solar pumps. And it should be online, so that the components are standardized, the farmers are getting the best quality of the pump, and the agencies can also monitor them easily. Creating payment structures which are suitable for companies to scale. I think we've been talking about Skill India, we've been talking about Make in India, but the payment structures, I don't know about everybody else, and I forgot to mention that I'm extremely humbled to be part of this dais, because I think out of all the companies present here today, we are like beyond startup stage. Everybody is pretty huge, you know. So we are an extremely working capital intensive industry. We basically have to incur most of our costs before setting up a project. The payment structures from the government usually never support in that. So how do more SMEs come into the sector? How do SMEs actually scale up? It is not possible, because financing becomes that much of an issue. So payment structures need to be also made in that way, or created in that way. Also, as I said, that there should be a unified countrywide agency. I think we are moving towards that. EESL, which is the Energy Efficiency Services Limited, is trying to do that. I think they're trying to become the unified agency for solar pumps and other kind of applications. They've released a huge order for EVs as well recently, but they're trying to become the unified agency for that. A little bit about us. We basically are a company which is into solar EPC, which is engineering, procurement, construction, part EPC as well, but we focus on the small to medium scale projects, which is up to the 4 megawatts and not beyond that. We have done very, very innovative projects. We take pride in that. We've done projects on ASDOCs. We've set up the world's first pump microgrid about 75 kilometers from here. It is an extremely interesting project where 10 farmers have created a cooperative and are selling power to the grid when they're not using the pumps. In fact, that has enabled Mr. Shankar to, in the last year, it has been about December 2015 since we set up that microgrid. And the farmers' income has increased by about 40%. It has not doubled, but it has increased by 40 to 50%. So that is the world's first project of its type, where a microgrid has been set up by us and a cooperative in a small village called Dundi, which is about 100 kilometers, 75-80 kilometers from here. We've received a couple of awards like the MICA, which is an institute here, with the Rising Sun Award and the Startup Champ Award in the energy sector. Just some of our projects. Thank you, sir. I know that. So yeah, these are some of the type of projects that we do. The rooftops, the ground mounts of say 1 megawatt scale, 2 megawatt scale. We've set up about 2,500 plus solar pumps now. I think by next year, so in 2019, I think we would have set up about not less than 10,000 solar pumps across the country. That is our aim. We hope we succeed in that. These are the kind of projects that we've done. So yes, that is pretty much from my side. Come embrace the sun, and I will not be there after the, just to mention that I'll not be there after the presentation. I have a wedding in my family, but in case any of you want to get in touch or have a chat or a chai, my email address is karan@shashwatcleantech.com. Thanks, bye-bye.